Hello, I'm Dr. Lee. Welcome to Practical Pain Management. I'd appreciate it if you could turn on the English caption for better communication. In the following up clinical case, I will select one interesting patient and follow up until discharge. I cannot guarantee the ultimate happy ending. I wish it would be a happy ending. It is a first case and first admission report. It could be a little stressful for me, but I hope you have more exciting and learn more from this new adventure. Let me describe her clinical history. She has had intractable right shoulder pain and severe limitation of range of motion. It has lasted for 6 months. She received the treatment of injection, medication, and physical therapy, but she feels that limitation of motion was worse. Here is the video of passive abduction, external rotation. Internal rotation. The passive RM test shows a capsular pattern of limitation. Passive abduction is 5 degrees. Passive external rotation is 15 degrees. Right shoulder reaches inferior gluteal region on passive internal rotation test. A simple X-ray AP shows diffuse cortical thinning and osteopenia in the humerus head and neck. These findings are prevalent in chronic shoulder pain with limitation of motion. Abduction AP view image shows a limitation of abduction of the glenohumeral joint. Only scapular abduction contributes the arm elevation. I couldn't find any pathology of rotator cuff with ultrasound examination. This scan is a long axial view of the biceps tendon. Transverse scan of the subscapularis tendon and bicipital groove. Long axial view of supraspinatus tendon. Long axial view of infraspinatus muscle and tendon. We are watching coronal T2 weighted image with fat saturation of the shoulder joint. There is a swelling and high signal intensity of anterior aspect of inferior capsule. You are looking at the sagittal T2 weighted image with fat saturation of the shoulder joint. There is a localized high signal intensity in the middle coracohumeral ligament. You can identify the diffuse high signal intensity along with the line of inferior capsule. I put sequential axial T2 weighted images cranial to caudal direction. There is localized high signal intensity in the middle aspect of coracohumeral ligament. I can identify the diffuse high signal intensity in the anterior and posterior aspect of inferior capsule. The anterior portion is more intensive. In summary, she has a severe capsular limitation of glenohumeral joint. There is osteopenia of the humerus head on X-ray due to long-term immobilization. The pathology is localized in the middle crocohumeral ligament, diffuse in the inferior capsule. Inferior capsular thickening and high signal intensity are more massive than crocohumeral ligament. Let's go to the clinical practice. I prepared two Luer-Lock syringes with 1.5 inch long needles. For targeting the crocohumeral ligament, I mixed the 25 unit of Botox with dexamethasone palmitate. And for targeting the inferior capsule, I prepared for 30 unit of Botox with 20 mg of triamcinolone. I'm going to target the right shoulder. Crocohumeral ligament is the first target. Look in the direction. Cranial, medial. My needle approaches from lateral to superior medial direction toward the middle crocohumeral ligament. To target the inferior capsule, I put the ultrasound probe along the humerus medial aspect, and my needle comes from inferior to superior direction. She has an inferior posterior capsular pathology, so I want to select a target from the inferior posterior aspect as well. I'm going to follow up in 2 weeks and later begin the home exercise program. If I did not satisfied with the increase of shoulder motion and pain, I would perform anesthetic manipulation. I would not prescribe any medication or physical treatment. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for the next follow-up video of this patient.